Being a student athlete means balancing a lot of different things. But for Hornet softball player Destiny Ojigoh, this spring has brought an extra significant event in her life.
I was born in Canada, and then we did a bunch of moving. So we went from Canada to New York to New Jersey to Virginia to Kansas City, Missouri. And we did that because my dad's job, he's a chemical engineer. And so when my brother turned 18, he's 3 years older than me, when he turned 18, my parents and my brother started the whole citizenship process all together. So they all got to like do it together, so I was on my own because I'm the baby in the family. So they went ahead and sent in their application, and like my dad's from Nigeria, my mom's from Ethiopia, so that's where they were trying to get their citizenship back from.
Ojigoh has also now taken the steps to obtain her U.S. citizenship. She believes watching her family go through the process made it all a little easier.
They had to do their biometric examination, so they go in and they like do fingerprints, so like you're in the system completely. And then they give you a booklet and it's 100 questions on it, and you just have to study for like this big test that you just gotta pass it. So, but yeah, I got to help my parents study, so like I already got like a little bit of a feel of like how the test was gonna go for when it was my turn to come. And then 3 years later, I became 18, and then they sent in my application, and then I did my biometrics, and then I did my test, and now I'm just May 21st is when my ceremony will be, and that's when I will like officially become a citizen.
Ojigoh went through much of this process during the softball season, which meant she had some extra support from her teammates.
It was really fun actually, because on the way to Arkansas actually, we were all on the bus and my teammates were all helping me study and they were all quizzing me, and it was just really funny because I would sit there and I'd ask them questions and they're citizens but they didn't know the answers. But it was really fun. My teammates and my coaches, they were all helping me study in between games on the buses, and I ended up doing really good, so I'm very thankful for them and all their help with it.
When you first went to Coach Rosal, she might have a little different story about you actually keeping her informed about all of this, but what did you tell her about the process?
So I first texted her and I was like, hey coach, I just want to let you know, like, I'm in the process of becoming a citizen, and so I have to go miss practice because I have to do my biometric examination. And so she called me right away and she was like, you're not a citizen? Like, she had no idea, which is crazy to me because I know I've talked about it so much at practice, like all my teammates knew, but I guess I never told her specifically. But she was really surprised and she was like, yeah, of course, I'm going to support you 100%, whatever you need, let's get this done. And then I tell her that my test is on this date, and I told her this in person, and she forgot all about it. And so I took my test and I became a citizen and everything.
Well, she didn't come to me. I got a text message saying that she would miss practice, or kind of a reminder that she would miss practice so that she could go do the first biometric thing. And from that point forward, I mean, you can't help but be ecstatic for her. It was something that completely caught me off guard. That's not something that, you know, you typically ask your players when you're recruiting them, hey, are you an American citizen? Unless you know they're from overseas. And so that's something that for me was new and has been a new process, but I think it's one that our team has kind of bonded over it, and it's kind of helped us out in that way too.
The Bobby D's story about the ceremony on May 21st. That's how you found out when she was going to be officially a citizen. Talk a little bit about that.
Yeah, and apparently I was lucky for it to be open to that page because otherwise it probably wouldn't have picked it up.
I went to Bobby D's with my roommate, Allie Barrett, and then she, like, they, like, put me in the paper for, like, becoming a citizen. And so she, like, flipped it to the front and put it on the front of Bobby D's. And then my coach just happened to come in the next day and saw it.
I went with my family and one of my best friends over to Bobby D's while she was in town. And just happened to be paying and saw the newspaper laying open to the back page, which Destiny has told me now that her roommate opened it to that page and kind of left it there because they were there the day before. So honestly, just by chance I found out about it, even though I asked her to make sure that we knew. And you know, it was just one of those things that that's Destiny. I don't always find out in the ways that I think I'm going to find out, but I eventually find out.
I already told her when my ceremony and everything was, but I guess she forgot.
For Ojigoh and head coach April Rosales, seeing everyone come together to help achieve this goal exemplified exactly what Hornet softball is all about.
It was a lot of fun, like, getting to mix softball and then my citizenship all together at once. Like, I'm so thankful for them. They, like, were just making, like, they continued to quiz me even when I was like, okay, like, I got it. They're like, no, like, you need to pass this test. We're not losing you. And they'd continue to, like, quiz me. So it was awesome to get to have them around during this process.
Well, that's our first core value is family over everything. And I think that's something that says a lot about the kids that we have in our program and the type of people that they are, the type of humans that they are. And you know, for them to just rally around anybody, and it would be anybody. It wouldn't. It's not just because it's Destiny. She just happens to be the benefactor this time. But there's been so many instances throughout, even this year, last year, that our team has really rallied around somebody. Everybody's just always happy for everybody else's success, and I think that's why you're starting to see the success that you're seeing on the field. It's kind of transforming and carrying over from off the field.
Ojigoh will be officially recognized as a U.S. citizen at her ceremony on May 21st at the Kansas City Public Library.
It's going to be a big relief for me and my family to like know like I'm for sure safe, like I'm not going anywhere, I'm going to be here for the rest of my life, but I'm just super excited for it because we've been working for it. It's been such a long process, so I'm excited.
We're happy for it and so happy that, you know, hopefully we can be a part of that too.
So like you said, you've been a lot of different places in the United States, but started out in Canada. But had you not, you know, come to America and decided to become a citizen, you know, got recruited to Emporia State, how do you think that life would be a little bit different right now?
I'm very thankful that I ended up here in Emporia, especially because I love Emporia. I love the school. I love the softball programs. I love all my friends, my teammates, everything about it's great. I don't think I would have liked being in Canada as much because I don't like the cold. It's a lot warmer over here, but I'm just really happy I ended up over here.